I'm going to show you how to combine two columns into one column. So for example, we have a list of material here, and we have the PO number, and then we have the material code. We want to make all of these numbers unique, so if we combine the PO number with the material code, then the number should be unique. So let's do it manually first. And so we're going to go equals, and we're going to select the PO, and then we're going to go the ampersand, and then we're going to go dash, and then we are going to select the material code. So what we do is we double click this, and it will complete the whole line. So this this works well, but sometimes you're doing it along with other tasks at the same time. So sometimes it would be nice to make this a macro so it would run automatically. So let's walk through the code that I've written for this. It's very simple. So I've declared I as an integer, and I've selected this worksheet, assuming that you have many worksheets. And so what I've done is column insert number one is I want to insert that for the first column. And do while I equals two, and that's because I have heading row. So do while cells in I2. Now this is a trick here, because we've inserted a row now, this column will be two. And so we have to adjust our values. Does not equal to, double quote, so does not equal blank. I'm going to put this code in the description, but it does not let me have square brackets in my description. So I'll have not symbol for not equal to here. Okay, so after that we go, so cells I1 equals cells I2, which is this one now, ampersand dash, and cells I4. And so let's, and then after we do that, then it automatically, or entire column AutoFit. So let's run this. And there you have your column with the dash values between the material and the PO put in there. So that's the two ways of combining two columns into one column. Please subscribe.